Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I have another amp dyno video for you. This time I have a Sony amplifier, the XM2100G. It features a nice cover which hides the connection points and the adjustment knobs. The amplifier is rated 100 watts into a foam load with 0.03% THD, 180 watts into a 2 ohm load at 0.08% THD, and 210 watts into a 1 ohm load at 0.1% THD. The amplifier features two fuses, 30 amps each, and the power connectors, battery plus, ground and remote. And here on the other side you have the RCA inputs and the speaker connectors. It has a bass boost knob at 40 Hz up to 10 dB and a gain knob. So let's see what it can do on the dyno.
The Sony amplifier is connected to the dummy loads and I use 2 4-ohm resistors in series to simulate an 8-ohm bridged mono load so I can test the output power into a 4-ohm load per channel, both channels driven. I start with a continuous power test, 1 kHz. Let's take this, the top of the waveform with my cursor. And I think we can calculate with 63 volts. I have an output power of 127 watts into a foam load per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test, this time 50 Hz input signal. Signs of clipping here, yes. I reduce. So it looks okay, I guess. And it says 62 volts. I also go to the top of the waveform. And we can calculate with 62.5 volts. With a 50 Hz input signal, the amplifier puts out 125 watts into a foam load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test, 1 kHz, 20 cycles. And I go to the last cycle. And now I'm going to increase my input signal to check if the cycle is starting to clip. There we have clipping. No clipping. Starts to clip. I reduce a little bit more. I think we can use this. Now I go to the whole burst. Lowest cycle has a voltage of 63.6, 129.6 watts. Dynamic power test with 8 cycles. There we have the last cycles. I increase. Clipping starts here, I go back. That's okay. And all cycles are at the same voltage level. Let's take 65.2 volts, 136.2 watts into a foam load per channel, both channels driven. Now I'm testing what the amplifier is able to put out for just 1 millisecond. The cycle looks dirty, check this out, but I'm going to go to the top of the waveform and it says 68 volts. No, yes, 68 volts. And I calculate with 68 volts at the cursor position. For just 1 millisecond, the amplifier is able to put out 148 watts into a foam loop per channel, both channels driven. I just made another 1 kHz continuous power test and this time I am at 64 volts. So I will add this value into the datasheet. After the second run, the amplifier is able to put out 131 watts into a foam load per channel, both channels driven, with a continuous power input signal of 1 kHz. Let's have a look at the amplifier's efficiency. I'm going to take out my clamp meter and check out how many amps the amplifier will pull out of my power supply. Here you can see the idle current and now I give full input signal. It pulls 27.8 amps. The amplifier has an efficiency of 66.8%. And now I connected just a 4 ohm resistor bridge mounted to the amplifier to get the output power into 2 ohms per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test. 2 ohms per channel, 1 kHz. Clipping. That doesn't look good. I reduce. This looks like a nice sine wave signal. And it says I got 55.2 volts. I go to the top of the waveform. And we can calculate with 55.2 volts. The amplifier delivers 195.3 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Continuous power test, but this time with 50 Hz. So it looks okay, I think. And the top of the waveform says 55 volts. The amplifier delivers around 194 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test, 20 cycles, 1 kHz. Just the first burst, you see highest value goes down to this. So I go to the last cycle, make sure it's clip free. So I gotta reduce my input signal because they are clipped, strongly clipped. That looks okay. Check if they are all at the same voltage level. So the first one isn't higher, as I mentioned before, because the negative waveform is also lower. So we take only the last cycle for voltage reading. And we have higher output voltage. We have 58 volts. With 20 cycles, the amplifier delivers 215.7 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test with 8 cycles. I go to the last cycle. I increase. That starts to clip. Looks okay. I go to all the other cycles. This one is higher, but this one is lower, so we don't use the first cycle. We have a voltage of 59 volts. With 8 cycles, the amplifier delivers 223.2 watts into a 2 ohm per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test for just 1 millisecond. Starts to clip. We have a peak voltage of 67 volts. For just 1 millisecond in this kind of waveform, which looks very dirty, the amplifier delivers around 287.8 watts. And I'm pulling out my clamp meter to check the efficiency at 2 ohms per channel. The amp pulls 47.7 amps. I calculated an efficiency of 60%. And now I connected 2 1-ohm resistors in series and connected them mono 2 ohms bridged to the amplifier to test the output power into a 1 ohm load per channel. Continuous power test, 1 kHz. That looks like a clean output voltage. We have 46 volts. The amplifier delivers 264.5 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. 50 Hz. I hope not to run the amplifier into hard clipping, this will cause the fuses to blow. Still goes, I go back. Looks not good. This looks okay, I think. And I have a peak voltage of 43.5 volts. The amplifier delivers 236.6 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven with a 50 Hz input signal. amplifier is fused with 60 amps, and let's see how many amps the amplifier will pull out of the power supply if I drive it with a continuous input signal of 1 kHz into a 2 ohm mono load, that means 1 ohm per channel. 74.6 amps, 7 amps. I calculated an efficiency of 52.1%. Dynamic power test, 20 cycles. I'm going to check the last cycle. It's free of clipping. Maybe I can raise the input signal a little more. But that leads to more clipping. We can take here the top of the waveform. And we are at 48 volts. With 20 cycles, the amplifier delivers a dynamic power of 288 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. 8 cycles. And I observe the last one. It's free of clipping. I try to increase my signal, but it goes into clipping. That looks okay. We have a peak voltage of, looks like 50 volts. We can calculate with 50 volts. With 50 volts, the amplifier delivers 312.5 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test for just one cycle, that means 1 millisecond of peak RMS output power. And I have one cycle catched, and the peak voltage is around 61.5 volts. You see that this negative waveform looks terrible, so I will try a test with 2 cycles. Maybe the second one will look much better. You see this here, the second cycle looks way better.
Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time for another AmpDyno video.